गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबडी। आई बी संध्या रानी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, जीडीसी मोहब्बत। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अमाइंस। इन दिस अमाइंस वी विल डिस्कस सम टॉपिक्स लाइक क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ अमाइंस, नॉमेक्लेचर, प्रिपरेशन ऑफ अमाइंस, बेसिक कैरेक्टर ऑफ अमाइंस, comparative basic strength of ammonium, methylamine, dimethylamine, trimethylamine. These topics we will be covered today's lesson. First of all, we go for the what are the amines. Amines are the compounds formed when one or two or three hydrogen atoms are removed from the ammonia molecule or substituted by the alkyl or aryl groups are called amines. Here we show, for example, first we take ammonia, that is NH3, loss of one molecule, that is one hydrogen atom, replaced by one alkyl group, that is CH3 group. So we will get methyl amine. Then another hydrogen is replaced by one more alkyl group, then we will get dimethyl amine. And once again we remove the last hydrogen atom from ammonia, we get trimethyl, replaced by alkyl group, we get trimethyl amine. Then we will go for the classification of amines. It is depends upon the number of alkyl groups or aryl groups present on a nitrogen atom in ammonia is called, we can classify it into the four types. So amines are classified basically broadly, these alkyl and or aryl groups, into four types. One is primary amines, second one is secondary amines, third one is tertiary amines, and last one is the quaternary ammonium salts or amines. This is a broad way of categorized amines into four groups. First of all, we will go for the primary amine. If one hydrogen atom in ammonia is replaced by the alkyl group, that is CH3 group, or aryl group, that is C6H5 group, is called as a primary amine. The general formula is RNH2 or alkyl NH2 or aryl NH2, that is ARNH2. For example of alkyl NH2 is the methylamine. For example, aromatic amine is called as the aniline. Here we show the structure of methylamine, that is CH3 add as a NH2 and benzene ring containing NH2, that is aniline, is the aromatic amine, that is called as the primary amine. These are the examples for primary amine. Then go for the secondary amine. The two hydrogen atoms in ammonia is replaced by the two alkyl groups, that is methyl groups, or two aryl groups, is called as the secondary amine. The general formula is R2NH2, or aromatic AR2NH2, or RNH aromatic. Here we see in structure, in ammonia two hydrogens are replaced by the alkyl groups or aryl groups. So these are called secondary amines. In tertiary amine, the three hydrogen atoms in ammonia are replaced by the three alkyl groups. The amine is called the tertiary amines. Tertiary amine general formula is R3N. So total number of hydrogen atoms are replaced by the alkyl groups. Then last one is the quaternary salts or tetraalkyl ammonium salts. In these compounds, the nitrogen is attached by four alkyl groups or existing as a tetraalkyl ammonium cation. So to neutralize this positive charge, it combines with a halide ion and forms ammonium salts. The general formula of quaternary ammonium salts is R3N plus X minus. So it neutral to become neutral, it combines with the halogen atom, that is halide atom. So here we see the quaternary ammonium salt. Then nomenclature, how it is called these amines. The amines, first of all we call, first amine functional group is indicated by the suffix amine in IUPAC nomenclature. This means that the last letter E of alkane is removed and amine term is added in place of it. So here one example is given there. Methane plus amine, methanamine, like that. Ethane plus amine, ethanamine. So suffix is indicated the amine functional group. So from alkane, E is removed with the amine group and called as alkanamine. That is a general nomenclature. Then aliphatic amines, these are named both by common and IUPAC system. Common system is, according to this system, the amines are named by prefixing the names of the nitrogen attached to the alkyl groups to the word amine. If substituents are identical, the prefixes di or tri employed. Here some example is quoted here. First of all, methyl amine, ethyl amine, these are the general formulas of amines, general nomenclature. Methyl amine, ethyl amine, dimethyl amine. In this third structure, two alkyl methyl groups are attached with the ammonia, so this is called a dimethyl amine. Then here in fourth structure, ammonia is combined, left side is methyl group and right side is the ethyl group. So it is named as a methyl ethyl amine. Then in fifth structure, three methyl group is attached around the nitrogen atom. So this is called trimethyl amine. Here the isopropylene is added to the ammonia, so it is called the isopropyl amine or primary amine. Why? Because the nitrogen atom is bonded with the primary carbon also. Then IUPAC system, according to this system, primary amines are named as the amino derivatives of corresponding alkanes. The secondary and tertiary amines are regarded as an alkyl substituted derivatives of amines. For example, here so many examples are given to you. One is here primary methyl amine. First of all, we can say the alkyl group and substituted by the amine. Methanamine. Here ethyl group is attached to the ammonia, so ethanamine. And here the nitrogen group, around nitrogen group, two methyl groups is added, so it is called as 2-methyl, normal methyl methanamine. Then here fourth structure, one side, left side is the methyl group, right side is the ethyl group, so it is named as a N-methyl ethanamine. Then in fifth structure, three alkyl groups around the nitrogen atom is added, so it is called as a N-dimethyl methanamine. Like that we can be nomenclate in IUPAC name. Here in this structure, nitrogen, left side is methyl group side and upside is the ethyl group and right side also ethyl group. So is called as N-ethanamine. And next structure, we'll go to the next structure. Here, amino group is combined with propane. So it is called as 1-propanamine. The numbering also here given, that is 1-propanamine. Last structure, amino group is combined with 2-methylpropane. In second carbon, in propane, second carbon containing 1-methyl group. So it is called as a 2-methyl-1-propanamine. So this is the IUPAC nomenclature. Then we'll go for the aromatic amines. The simplest aromatic amines are called as aniline, and its methyl homologues are named as ortho or meta positions and para toluidines. For example, near first structure, just benzene ring contains one aniline, NH2 group, amino group contains, so it is called as aniline. The second one is in ortho position, it contains methyl group. So already we have said that this is the aniline substituted methyl homologue. So toluenes like that. Here first ortho side is methyl group contains, so ortho methyl aniline. In third structure, the methyl group is substituted in para meta position, so it is called meta methyl aniline. In last structure, methyl group is binded at para position of benzene, so it is called named as a para methyl aniline. Then this is for nomenclature of aliphatic and aromatic amines, that is aryl and aliphatic amines, alkyl amines. Then we will go for the preparation of amines. The first one is the ammonolysis of alkyl halides. When alkyl halide is heated with an aqueous or alkali solution of ammonia in a sealed tube at 100 degree centigrade, then a mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amines along with quaternary ammonium salts will be formed. So it is a nucleophilic substitution reaction. In this reaction, multiple alkylation occurs and a mixture of primary, secondary, tertiary alkyl amines and quaternary ammonium salts will be formed. So removal of one hydrogen in place of alkyl group is substituted so that we can get the mixture of primary, secondary, tertiary and quaternary ammonium salts are formed. In aryl halide do not react with ammonia easily. This is because the partial double bond is present between the halogen and benzene ring. If electron withdrawing groups are present in the benzene ring, then halogen can be easily replaced by amino group. Here we see the first reaction. Alkali ammonium react with the alkyl halide and gives the primary amine. Replace of halogen element with the ammonia, that is amino group, and gives hydrogen halide. In second reaction, the primary amine react with one mole of alkyl halide and gives secondary amine. Then secondary amine react with one mole of alkyl halide and gives tertiary amine. Like that, the replacement of halogen group with the amino group. Lastly, we will get the tetraalkyl ammonium halide. Then go for the reaction mechanism. First of all, nitrogen contain a lone pair electron in ammonia, so it delocalized to the alkyl group. Then halogen group is removed from that, so loss of one electron pair from nitrogen, it becomes a positive ion. So gaining of one pair electron, halogen become negative ion. Then in hydrolysis, in presence of alkaline aqueous, it became the primary amine. Like that in ammonia, one ethyl bromide, it contains react with ethyl bromide, then ethyl group delocalization of lone pair from ethylene group, then nitrogen became positive nature and bromide became negative nature, then in presence of ammonia it became the primary amine and ammonium NH, positive nature of ammonium will be formed. Then in last reaction, these primary amine react with another one, then we will get the secondary amine. So like that, the lone pair of electrons of nitrogen replaced by the alkyl group, and the halogen became the negative group and nitrogen became the positive group, and loss of halogen from this structure, we can get the amines. This is the ammonolysis of alkyl halides. Then second one is the Gabriel synthesis. In this reaction, thalamide is treated with potassium hydroxide to form a potassium thalamide. This react with alkyl halide to give an alkyl thalamide. This is further hydrolysis of this alkyl halide with sodium hydroxide gives a primary amine. See this, in this reaction, thalamide in presence of potassium hydroxide, it loses one hydrogen molecule and replaced by the potassium molecule. So we get the potassium thalamide. Then it react with the alkyl halide, that is RX, and form this potassium is replaced by the alkyl group. So we can get the N-alkyl thalamide. So that this N-alkyl thalamide in basic solution, that is sodium hydroxide aqueous solution, it undergoes the hydrolysis and we can found a sodium salt, that is, and primary amine. This is the Gabriel synthesis. Then another one is the Hafman bromamide reaction. When an amide, that is aliphatic or aromatic, is treated with bromine and potassium hydroxide, we can get primary amines. Here primary amide is treated with the halogen element, that is chlorine or bromine, with sodium hydroxide, that is basic medium, we can get primary amine and sodium halide and sodium carbonate and two moles of water molecule. For example, methyl amide is treated with chlorine and sodium hydroxide, we can find methyl amine. So that we can found the aliphatic or aromatic with treating with the primary amine, we can get to primary amine. We see the mechanism. Mechanism of Hofmann's of degradation involves the following steps. In first step, it involves the halogenation, that is the removal of one hydrogen molecule and it is replaced by the one halogen molecule. In this reaction, here hydrogen is replaced by bromine, so bromamide will be formed. In second step, it involves the reaction with potassium hydroxide, then bromide is removed by the potassium salts. So like that, in third step, it involves the halide ion into species having the electron deficient group atom. So from the nitrogen atom, the electrons will be shifted to the bromine. So in fourth step, alkyl group, that is methyl group, migrates from the carbon to nitrogen to form alkyl isocyanate, that is methyl isocyanate. So nitrogen contained lone pair electron is shifted to the carbon atom, then bond will be shifted to the carbon nitrogen double bond, so methyl isocyanate will be formed. In the last step, alkyl isocyanate is hydrolyzed to form a primary amine in presence of alkali media. So in alkali media, this methyl isocyanate gives methyl amine, that is a primary amine. Then reduction of amides. Reduction, it means adding of one hydrogen molecules. So amides, some reagents, that is lithium aluminium hydride. So in amides, in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, undergo hydrolysis and gives the primary amine. The C double bond O will be the cleavage and add 2 moles of hydrogen to the carbon, so that we can find amide on reaction with aluminium, lithium aluminium hydride undergoes reduction reaction and gives the primary amine. Then another one here, secondary amide is react with lithium, same lithium aluminium hydride reagent, that is the reduction reagent. It gives 2 moles of hydrogen to the carbon, and C double bond O will be cleaved and adding of 2 moles of hydrogen atoms to the carbon, then it will form a secondary amide. Same like that, in tertiary amide, same in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, we can get tertiary amines. Like that, on reduction of amides in presence of lithium aluminium hydride, we will get the primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Then another one is the Schmidt reaction. In presence of concentrated sulfuric acid, carboxylic acids react with hydrazoic acid, that is H3N is called as the hydrazoic acid, and form the primary amine is called as a Schmidt reaction. In this reaction, sulfuric acid or any Lewis acid is used as a catalyst. Primary amines are formed. The amine formed in this reaction has one carbon atom less than the taken carboxylic acid. So less number of carbon atoms will be formed in primary amine, which one we are used in carboxylic acid carbon numbers. Here we see the mechanism. The carboxylic acid is, that is RCOOH, in presence of acidic media, here one hydrogen atom will be added to the oxygen, then one proton is added, so it becomes O plus. In hydrolysis, the hydrazoic acid, it loses of one water molecule and became the RC double bond O plus. Then it react with the hydrazoic acid, the intermediate compound will be formed. In hydrazoic acid, it becomes a nitrogen-nitrogen triple bond. Then this triple bond is attached to the C double bond O CH. Then we can get the fifth step. From this we can get carbon dioxide and primary amine. Then we will, these are the preparation methods of amines. 4 types of methods is there. Then one is the, then we will discuss for the basic characters of amines. The basic character is due to the presence of unshared or lone pair electron pair and nitrogen atom. Due to this, nitrogen atom in amines accepts protons. So the readiness which the lone pair of electrons is available for coordination with a proton determines the relative basic strength of amines. So in this structure, primary amine, secondary amine and tertiary amine. So in ammonia, nitrogen contains one lone pair electron. Due to this positive inductive effect of alkyl groups, that is plus I group, the nitrogen atom becomes strongly electronegative due to this. The lone pair of electrons on nitrogen atoms is more readily available than in ammonia. Hence, amines are stronger bases than ammonia. So, the basicity of amine should increases with increase in number of alkyl groups. So, the basicity of different amine should be in the following order. That is, the tertiary is greater than, secondary is greater than, then primary, and then greater than ammonia. But the actually decreasing order of basic strength is secondary is greater than, tertiary is greater than primary, because the alkyl group around nitrogen atom causes crowding of decrease the availability of lone pair. This is called as a steric hindrance effect. This result in the fall of basic strength. So in methyl amine, one lone pair is there, one methyl group is there, this plus I group. Then here dimethyl, two alkyl groups are there. In trimethyl, the number of methyl group increased, so the crowding of electron density will be increased around the nitrogen. So this resulting the steric hindrance, steric effect, so that the basicity will be falling down of tertiary trimethyl amine. So that's why the basic strength of the amines is secondary is greater than, tertiary is greater than, primary is greater than ammonia. Then comparatively basic strength of ammonia, methyl amine, dimethyl amine, trimethyl amine, in all these compounds unshared pair of electrons is present on nitrogen atom. Hence these are basic in structure nature. Methyl group is the alkyl group, that is plus I group. So increasing the number of methyl group causes in the an increase in this basic strength. Hence trimethyl amine must be highly basic molecule, but due to the bulky groups of three methyl groups are situated around the nitrogen atom, so that resulting to the steric effect of trimethyl amine, the basicity will be decreased in tertiary trimethyl amine. Thank you for this. Today's lecture will be closed. Tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you.